Good morning, everyone. This is the VG247 Bulletcast coming to you from Sydney. It's August 17, the second day of Gamescom. There's so much to get through, I'm just going to leap straight into it. First up, the featured conference. We've got reports on Microsoft's Play Day, EA and Sony's press conferences on the site. Johnny, Pat and Alex are in attendance, so there's plenty of good details there. Also on the ground at Gamescom, we spoke to Microsoft, who said that there's plenty more potential to do more with the Gears of War universe. They're talking about cross-media opportunities, so comic books, movies, as well as forthcoming games. So expect to see more of, what are their names, Marcus and Dom and the boys. Johnny got hands-on with a bunch of Vita titles, including Uncharted Golden Abyss, which he was very impressed by, so be sure and read that. Speaking of Sony, they released a massive number of assets. So Steph's made two roundups of the screen, so you should go and feast on those with your eyeballs. Back on the ground now at the show, we spoke to Rare, who said that Kinect Sports 2 is a true Rare game at heart, which is nice. And regarding Kinect Star Wars, we've been told that it offers finesse in combat. So not the sort of flaily thing that you might have expected. Finally, from Microsoft, the Gunstringer is going to be released at retail because it felt like a retail game, so a full experience rather than a downloadable game. So that's interesting. Elsewhere, Microsoft is looking into German releases for Gears of War 1 and 2, which didn't make it through ratings the first time after the surprise acceptance of Gears of War 3. So that's good news for Germany. Good news for Australia, Catherine's been picked up for local release. So wasn't really expecting that. That's good news. Microsoft's announced a season pass for Age of Empires Online, which for $99 will give you a 30% discount on everything for the first 6 months. Unfortunately, they've only announced about $45 worth of stuff right now, so it might be a little while before you consider that a thrifty option. It does give you an idea of the sort of scale of content they're expecting to introduce. Shuhei Yoshida, who's the head of Sony Worldwide Studios, and their 3D chief, Mick Hocking, have had a chat about where they expect gaming to go, and have said some pretty amazing things are going to happen in the next 10 years, like holodecks and virtual characters so real you can't tell the difference, that sort of thing. So you can go read their speculation. It's informed. Analysts have said that the PlayStation 3 price cut announced during the Sony press conference is going to boost the industry a little bit, restore confidence, so that's good news after the very depressing NPDs. Still with Sony, Vita dev kits apparently cost quite a lot less than either of those for PSP and PS3. That's good news, which because it means we might get more games. Warface, Crytek's free-to-play shooter, is going to see Western release. Previously we thought it was only coming out in Asia. This is great news, it might help propel free-to-play back into the... Well, it's already coming into the mainstream, but convince a few hardcore hearts that they can have a good time even without coughing up money straight away. Speaking of free-to-play, Dota 2 beta signups are now available, so go ahead and sign up. Oh, while you're there, bookmark the Secret Worlds website because they'll also be taking beta signups on August 26th. It's good news, very excited about that. Ubisoft's announced its launch lineup for the PlayStation Vita. They always like to support new console launches, and they've got Assassin's Creed in there, which is good news. Halo Anniversary maps are going to be exportable and available separately as DLC, so you'll be able to play them in other Halo titles. That's fantastic news for those who are fans of the original. Epic's developing 5 new games and has pretty much said that it considers the PC a primary platform, which is not really surprising because they were quite heavily involved in the PC Gaming Alliance before it sort of lost a bit of steam. PopCap has said that working on EA properties would really make sense, which is probably true, so it'll be interesting to see how that plays out. There's a demo for Body Count available now on Xbox Live, and it's coming to the PSN tomorrow, I think. You should probably check that out. That's from Codemasters. They make great games, and it's a bit crowded market at the moment, so give that one some love. And finally, a report suggests that the 3DS price cut has managed to shift 215,000 3DS units in 1 week. So, wow, that's a lot of enthusiasm for a slightly lower price. A largely lower price, I should say. Now, we've got a huge number of trailers. So, we've got Devil May Cry, Dead Rising 2 off the record, Asura's Wrath. Oh, here's a good one from Capcom as well. Steel Battalion Heavy Armor. You should definitely check that out. We've got some screens there as well and some artwork. They're talking about it having a hybrid control system where you use the control pad for moving and aiming, but you can do a whole bunch of other things with Kinect, like standing up to look out the turret and control the machine gun there and slapping your crewmates when they panic. That bit, I think, is quite good. We've got the Dark Souls trailer. We've got a multiplayer fly-through with developer commentary of Halo Combat Evolved Anniversary. So that's the maps you can export, so that's definitely worth taking a look at. There's a Prototype 2 teaser, but it's a bit short, doesn't really deliver. Resident Evil Revelations, on the other hand, certainly delivers. It's got three videos. One of them is a cinematic and two of them are in-game. Looking quite good on the old 3DS there, the new 3DS. Got a Dance Central 2 video, Johnny's not in it. An announcement trailer for an MMO called Otherland. It was actually announced quite a while ago, but it's looking quite insane and also really good. That's based on the Tad Williams franchise. We've got a FIFA 12 gameplay trailer and a Battlefield 3 64 multiplayer video, as well as an SSX trailer and a Mass Effect 3 gameplay trailer. All that's come out of EA. They really brought some big guns out. Not enough Liara in the Mass Effect 3 trailer, obviously. There's also a Forza Motorsport 4 trailer that shows the making of the Hockenheim track. Is that a track? I don't know what that is. Oh, I'm back with EA, I've missed one. Kingdoms of Amalur: Reckoning. I haven't watched that one yet, that should be quite good. There's another one for Resistance 3 called Follow Capelli, which is based on vintage artwork, so it's really rather stylish for, you know, shooters' trailers tend to be quite boring. So that one's good. Uncharted 3, still with Sony. It looks gorgeous. Doesn't Uncharted always look gorgeous? Yeah, it looks gorgeous again. And Infamous 2, Festival of Blood, which is an adventure where vampires take over the city of Infamous 2 and Cole has one night to find a cure. There's one for Journey, which is shockingly beautiful, and a Starhawk one, which is unfortunately purely cinematic, but it's pretty dramatic. One of the most interesting ones is Wipeout 2048, because it shows gameplay from the Vita, which is something we haven't seen a hell of a lot yet. And finally, there's one for The Secret World, the next one in their series of cinematic trailers. You'll recognise some of the characters if you've been following it, but the three factions face off against something else this time, which is kind of cool. All right, that's it. There'll be plenty more today, I'm sure, as the rest of the assets roll out and news will start pouring in. Johnny, Pat, and Alex should be getting up quite soon, so we'll be able to tell you what they've got planned for us. So just stay glued to VG247. Never look away. Why would you ever? All right, see you tomorrow.